More controversy tonight and a stunning admission concerning the private security firm Blackwater USA, hired and paid millions by the State Department here to protect its employees in Iraq. Jonathan Beale covers the State Department for the BBC, and he joined me a brief time ago with a new twist. So, Johnny, what is the new twist?
Well, on Capitol Hill, there has been a deep concern, particularly amongst Democrats, about the oversight of private security contractors operating in Iraq, firms like Blackwater. And today, one of the committees was hearing evidence from the Inspector General of the State Department, a man named Howard Krongard. Now, he is the man responsible for ensuring that the State Department spends its money wisely, but also that it operates ethically. There have been questions as to whether Mr. Krongard has family links to Blackwater. Earlier in testimony, he denied that his brother had any financial dealings with Blackwater. But then suddenly, after a break in proceedings, he changed the story. This is what he said.
During the break, I did contact my brother. I reached him at home. He is not at the hotel. But I learned that he had been at the advisory board meeting yesterday. I had not been aware of that. And I want to state on the record right now that I hereby recuse myself from any matters having to do with Blackwater.
That's astonishing. So this is the man in charge of ethics at the State Department suddenly saying that his brother sits on the board of Blackwater.
Yeah, and you could almost see the jaws drop in the committee, because until that point, Republicans have been defending him against what they saw as essentially politically motivated attacks on his name. But understandably, after that revelation, the committee pressed him on why hadn't he come clean.
When did you have your first conversation with your brother about whether he was affiliated with Blackwater?
I only had one. And I should make clear, as I tried to say, I'm not my brother's keeper, and we do not discuss
our business with each other. You are a witness here, and you have testified in the past, and you got this body relying on your testimony.
And my testimony,
so if you're not your brother's keeper, you need to say, we don't know, or something like that.
Say,
you can't say, quote, my brother's not on the Blackwater board.
As far as I knew, that was a correct statement then. It turns out it was the best knowledge that I had.
Not a great day for the State Department, and certainly a pretty black day for Blackwater. Tie this in together with the report in the New York Times today that 14 of those 17 killings of Iraqi civilians in September were unprovoked.
Yeah, I mean, we should first of all say that the FBI investigation is ongoing, but the evidence given to the New York Times, and this is from unnamed officials, both in the military and civilian officials, is that the Blackwater security guards in that incident were not fired upon first, that they opened fire, that they were responsible for killing 14 of those 17 Iraqi civilians, that they used their force recklessly. There are contrary comments tonight from ABC News, quoting a Blackwater guard who says he was definitely fired upon. So it's still murky. But what you can say is that we already know the State Department's head of diplomatic security has resigned over this whole affair, questions about Blackwater. And tonight, Mr. Krongard's position is very, very uncomfortable.